What black market existed in your school? Teachers punished us by making us write "I will refrain from extemporaneous vocalization during valuable pedagogical opportunities 50 or 100 times as homework. So over the summer we would do up a few hundred sheets of that, and we could sell or use them as necessary. Posted about this before. I sold pronoun mags at a choir after Japanese businessmen would leave them in their motel rooms. My school banned soda. I used to keep a cooler full in my car and sell them for $2 a pop. The cafeteria, not school run, kind of just a cafe inside the school, would charge $3-4 for a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, so one girl kept the ingredients in her locker and charged $1. When the school caught wind and shut it down, they tried to guilt us all by saying how the cafeteria was someone's livelihood and we were taking away from that. But like, $4 for peanut butter? A pronoun ring. Kids would find their dad's VHS pronosaur magazines and sell them to this kid. Then he'd turn around and sell it for profit. Funny thing is that when the principal caught wind of it and found all the pronoun in his locker, but the money wasn't there, the kid used the locker under his and hid it all in the bottom. The pronoun hustler dude is now a cybersecurity analyst. I asked him at our reunion how much he thought he made back. TH he claims $900 in 4 months. Drugs and soda, same dude too. If you bought a soda from him during school, he'd know you weren't an arc and would then sell you weed after. My mum owned a sweet shop and sweets were banned in our school as we had to be healthy meals and all that. So she'd constantly give me bags of sweets to smuggle in and sell every day at dinner. Made an absolute bomb. I used to sell bootleg movies in high school. Not the kind of bootleg where you take a video camera into a theater, but I knew someone who kept getting early versions of movies that I guess are sent to theaters. They had some message about it being for screening purposes only / internal use, I don't remember exactly, and giving them to me. He'd burn a bunch of copies and sell them to people for $5. They were high quality and still early in theaters. Our high school had an internet filter. An enterprising friend of mine set up a free BSD server in his basement and put together some 256 MB flash drives with an executable version of Firefox could run directly from the flash drive without installs and a SSH client. You could plug it in, connect SSH, then use the server as a proxy for all the Firefox traffic and get around any website you wanted. Those flash drives were a hot commodity, let me tell you. You could set up in the library and just start casually browsing a banned website, and people would start coming up and asking how you could do it. Iodized salt and simple black pepper in the lunchroom. I'm not kidding. This was around 2004 USA. Our cafeteria coordinator was trying to do everything healthy and by government rules, so no added salt. Bogus, but whatever. But she also took the pepper too. Kids in my school didn't really pack lunches, as most of us got reduced lunch. I was pissed, as they just boiled canned veggies and gave them to you in a bowl with the juice, and wasn't going to stand for it. I was also a huge asshole in high school, so I made a plan. I bought salt and pepper shakers and put them in a zippy bag to carry in my backpack. I broke them out at lunch every day and shared with about 70 kids. We made it through for about 3 months, and then they finally caught on who had them. I got silent lunch detention in a separate room for a week, and I made sure I put my salt and pepper out on my table every day. But then, when I came back to the normal lunchroom, like 30 people had salt and pepper shakers. Shakers everywhere, and the coordinator was pissed. Oh, it makes me laugh even today. She still refused to put out salt and pepper, but we all had it anyway. It continued until I graduated from there. PlayStation 1 and 2 memory card stuck on a boss. Want the treasures without having to beat the game on ultra hard? There was a guy who in my grade who, for a fee, would play any game and get where you wanted to be, then give you a memory card to copy over the save file. Naturally, you had to return the memory card to keep the ball rolling for everyone. In 5th grade, I sold fairies to every single one of my classmates for $1 each. I gave them names and backstories and drew little portraits of each, then would toss them an invisible fairy and then collect from the next sucker. PPP's positive participation points. These were little yellow tickets that teachers handed out to students. who were participating positively. Every month there would be class-wide and school-wide draws for prizes. The more PPPs you had, the greater your chance of winning was. Didn't take long for kids to copy the template in Word and start selling stacks of PPPs. JanSport book bag strings. I was in school when JanSport backpacks became popular, at least in New York City they were, and one of the things everyone loved were the strings on the zippers. It became a huge problem where students were stealing strings off of others and either hoarding them or selling them. The solution became using a lighter to partially meld your strings together so they couldn't be untied without breaking them. Leaving your book bag unattended anywhere was the equivalent of leaving your car parked in the wrong neighborhood in 70s/80s New York City. Edit just remembered I ran a short-lived market selling scientific calculators back in high school as well. I actually found where the school stored those and was stealing them little by little. I'm not proud of it, but my morals were very loosey-goosey back th. Used to do commissions in drawing naked people. I studied in a boarding school, and we had a black market for acorns. Yes, acorns. Kids would collect the acorns from the ground, paint, and shape them so that they spin like Beyblades. The other kids would buy them to compete in the acorn battle, which is similar to Beyblade. In 8th grade 2001, I got a Playboy from my older sister's BF. I cut out the nudes and sold them one at a time to the rest of the guys I knew. A $5 magazine turned into clothes on $50. I didn't get caught, but a few days later another kid tried the same thing with one he stole from his dad's stash. He was caught. School tells his dad. Dad is unusually pissed off about it. Turns out it's dad's favorite issue BC. It was signed E. Crawford in the centerfold. Originally we only had vending machines in the field house, so people would give jocks money to go get them snacks and sodas. Eventually it became sort of like a service, with a fee of course. Some kids mimicked it with junk food from the convenience stores, and it became a black market of the rarest candies. Some kids were peddling stuff from Japan, others from the UK. It was a high stakes candy market of the best stuff. Ginger flavored Kit Kats, pear drops, Maltesers, blackcurrant chews, and more. Eventually the faculty began to notice strange ongoings on and alerted the principal, which found the whole thing rather amusing. A few weeks later, we had vending machines throughout the school, but for that one semester, it was a lawless land. Oh man, I was a high school black market. My sophomore year I believe, the school took all unhealthy snacks and drinks out of the vending machines, candy, soda. So I stepped up and filled the gap until I graduated. I started carrying around a backpack full to the brim with various full-size candy bars and sodas, all of which I would sell for $1. The sodas were the real money maker. I could get a 12-pack for $3 and make 300% profit. On a good day I would generally make around $10, and usually at the very least $3 or $4. The school did give me warnings a few times when they did locker checks and found several boxes of soda and candy bars, but I just claimed they were for me and nothing came of it. As a senior gift for my ski team, the underclassmen gave me a creepy trench coat from which to peddle my wares. It was great. The year after I left, another kid on the ski team stepped up and started offering the same service I've been told. Makes me happy to have left something of a legacy. In high school, a kid on the wrestling team had parents who constantly went out of town on business. So he drained their swimming pool and would host fight nights with the fights in the pool. It was called Beat That Ass. He facilitated betting and made himself more money than a high school kid should have. He tried to recruit anyone in the school who looked like they could hold their own in a fight. Eventually bands started playing at them, and he started burning CDs of each event's music. They were printed and numbered, so each one looked like the Now That's What I Call Music CDs, but instead of Now they said BTA. Source was in a band that was asked to play. We declined. Edit, he didn't empty and refill the pool for each event. He emptied it once, and it stayed empty. But his parents wouldn't have noticed, nor cared either way. Edit 2, it might have been called Whoop That Ass. I dunno. It's been a while. I sold packs of batteries for when people's T-84/83s were inevitably dead on test day. I don't know about black market, but We had two places you could be during recess: the gym or the playground. During the winter, the go-to was the gym. Underneath the bleachers in the gym, we legitimately had a Pokemon/UGR gambling ring in which kids would put up their lunch money. I later found out from one of the kids who ran this little exchange that it was actually heavily rigged. Shocker. I never got pocket money, so I used to do other people's maths homework on the bus for £1. The Pilot G5 liquid ink pens. You could sell them for $5 each all day. I was the pen guy. Bubble gum and chewing gum. It was in middle school. Huge, huge supply for chewing gum. Down the road there was a little cafe that sold those 5 packs of gum for 10 cents. I walked in with a $5 bill and bought as many as I wanted. I sold each stick at 25 cents each and 50 cents for Big Red. I made a huge profit. People started getting jealous, and I got into a few fights over the amount of gum I was selling. Finally, the school caught on and told the store not to sell gum to students anymore, and thus my days as a gum dealer ended. Not really black market, but I hope that counts. When I was in middle school, Beyblade was hyped. I was into it too, and found out that there are way newer ones in Japan but not here. Looked further and found fakes that looked almost like the real ones but way cheaper. You know where this is getting. Bought some for me to create interest in them, showed them the fake boxes all in Japanese, so they thought it's real, and bought a bunch of them. I made something between 400, 500 euro in half a year. Well, in college I happened to know all the people that could get me every drug imaginable. Like, forget that we also had chemical engineering students, one of which got caught making high quality meth to pay his student loans. Context: I went to an international school where everyone is rich as frick. So one day in first grade I brought some candy to school, and this rich white kid offered me 1 euro for a 10 cent sweet. This kept on happening for a week. At that point I started buying more candy and bringing it to school. I was filling my pencil case with candy and hiding the money I got from kids in a special rack that I made in my bag with a knife. I carried this on for 2 years until one time my mom was cleaning my bag so the cut and put her hand in, and to her surprise there was approximate 1000 euros. My parents beat me so hard I have never tried selling anything ever again. I was one of the first kids in my high school to have a scanner. This was back in the middle 90s and people just didn't really have them. My family did. Student parking passes were $150 each. I bought one and then scanned it and made duplicates that I would sell for $75 each. They looked okay, but the school never really checked them that good. They just wanted to see the little thing hanging from your rearview mirror and that it was the right color. The teachers had a different colored one. I stopped doing it after more people had parking passes than there were spaces in the lot.